Hey everyone, welcome back to Fix My Linux. Today we're diving into some of the most essential Linux terminal commands that every beginner, developer, and DevOps engineer should know. We won't just talk about them. We'll actually practice together, step by step. Whether you're on Ubuntu, Fedora, Linux Mint, or any other Linux distribution, these basics are universal. So open your terminal and let's start building your Linux skills from scratch. Alright, let's jump into our very first command, uname, check operating system. First command, check what system you're using. Type uname and you'll see it outputs Linux. That's because Linux Mint, Ubuntu, Fedora, all of them have Linux at their core. Uname-a, detailed system information, want more details about your system? Use. Uname-a, now you get full info, kernel version, machine architecture, and operating system. Very useful for troubleshooting or documentation. Whoami, find out your logged in user. When you're working remotely, sometimes you forget which user you're logged in as. Just type whoami. It will tell you your current username. Simple but very important. PWD, print current directory. Now let's see where exactly we are inside the file system. Type PWD, it shows the full path. For example, /home/fixmylinux. This helps you understand your current working location. Mkdir, create a new folder. Let's create a new directory or folder using mkdir server. If no error appears, the folder is created successfully. Ls, list directory contents. To confirm that your folder is created, list the contents. Else you'll see server listed, that's your new folder. Touch, create a new empty file. Now inside the server folder, let's create a new empty file. Use touch server config. This creates a file named config without opening any editor. Echo, add text into a file. Let's put some content inside that file. Use the echo command like this. Echo test configs server treat config. It appends test config into the config file. Cat view contents of a file. To see what's inside a file, use cat server config. It will display test config right on your terminal. Rm remove a file. Now let's delete that file. Use rm server config file deleted, and when you ls server, it should be gone. Rm remove a folder recursively. Folders need a special option to delete. To remove the server folder and everything inside, use rm-r server. Be careful, r stands for recursive deletion. Clear the terminal screen. After all that typing, your terminal might look messy. To clean it up, simply type clear or press Ctrl plus L, both will give you a fresh screen. Ping test internet connection. Let's check if your machine can reach the internet by sending ping requests. Type this command, ping-c3google.com. The -c3 option tells it to send 3 ping packets and then stop. If you see replies with bytes from google.com, congratulations, your network is up and running. Curl, fetch web pages or APIs from terminal. Now let's test our local web server using curl. Type curl localhost. If nginx is running, you'll see a message like welcome to nginx. This proves your web server is active and accessible. Cd, navigate into a directory. To move into a different folder in Linux, we use cd, which stands for change directory. Let's go into the default nginx webpage directory, cd /var/www/html. Now we're inside /var/www/html, which is where nginx keeps its default website files. Cp, copy a file. Suppose we want to create a backup of the main webpage. Use the cp command like this, cpindex.nginx-dbn.html index.nginx-dbn.html_cp. This creates a copy of index.nginx-dbn.html with _cp at the end inside the same folder. Mv move or rename a file. If you want to rename or move a file, we use the mv command. Let's rename the original file mvindex.nginx-dbn.html index.nginx-dbn.html backup. Now if you list files with ls, you'll see the file is renamed. This is how we manage files efficiently. ls-l, view detailed list of files. To get a more detailed view of files and directories, use ls-l. This will show permissions, ownership, file size, and last modified date. Important when checking who owns which file and what access is allowed. Nano, create or edit files inside terminal. Now let's create a new web page manually using a simple text editor called nano. Type sudo nano index.html inside nano. Type a message, for example, welcome to local nginx server, then press Ctrl plus X to save changes and exit. Now list files again, ls-l. You will see your newly created index.html file in the folder. Chown and chmod manage file ownership and permissions. First, let's change the ownership of the file to your username using the chown command. Sudo chown fixmylinux:fixmylinux-index.html. Now you own the index.html file. Verify it by listing again, ls-l. You'll see your username there. Next, let's change the permissions of the file using chmod. Let's make it readable and writable only by the owner. Chmod 600index.html. Now, only the owner can read and write. Others cannot access it. Try accessing the web page again using curl. Curl localhost. You'll get a 403 forbidden error because the web server running as a different user can't read the file anymore. To fix it, we need to reset ownership back to root and set proper permissions. Sudo chown /root:index.html, sudo chmod 644:index.html. Now try curl again, curl localhost, and your web page loads successfully. Always remember, 644 permission equals owner can read chart write, others can only read. 600 permission equals only owner can read chart write, others denied. Grep, search for text in files. Suppose you want to find files or lines containing a specific keyword. Use grep. First, list files containing index in the name ls-pipe-grep-index. It will list any file name that has the word index inside it. Super useful when troubleshooting configuration files, find locate files by name. Finally, if you want to search the entire directory tree for a file by name, use find. For example, to search for any file with welcome in its name, find .namewelcome. This will search from the current directory downward for matching file names. Very powerful when working on big projects. You can also cross-check with cat and grep. Cat web server 1/index.html pipe grep welcome. This shows the lines inside the file where welcome appears. That's it for today's Linux basics practice. We learned not just the commands, but also how they behave in real scenarios. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to Fix My Linux channel. Drop your questions in the comments. I'm here to help you. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next session.